My name is Harvinder Singh Sethi. I am from GE Lake System. Today I am going to discuss about what is magnetic flux. Flux is a Latin word which means flow of something. Now, when we are talking about magnetic flux, we will be talking about magnetic field lines. What are magnetic field lines? Magnetic field lines are imaginary lines which starts from north pole of a magnet and ends to that of a south pole of a magnet. So, if we want to study magnetism in detail, we should know what exactly magnetic flux means. So, what does magnetic field actually depends upon? That is the main thing which we should study first. First of all, magnetic field depends upon something, the most important thing is its strength. If the magnet has a weak magnetic strength, then it won't be able to pull larger objects or a small object to a greater extent. What does pulling exactly mean? Pulling means flow of lines. Flow of lines will make the inner atoms to align in a manner parallel to the direction of flux. Let's not go in that deeper section right now. First, let's just understand what is magnetic flux. Magnetic flux actually stands for the amount of magnetic lines passing through a given surface. So, when I said the factors which on it depends, so one of them is magnetic strength. If the magnetic strength is more, so the magnetic field lines passing through that object will be greater compared to that of a lesser one. Okay, second thing which I am going to discuss is about the area. Area of what? Area of conductor. Because magnetic field lines are going to pass through the area. Larger the area of a conductor, more will be the field lines passing through it. Now, to put this entire thing in a simple and short equation. Just a second. I like to make this equation and then explain to everyone. B A cos theta is equal to phi. Guys, what exactly is phi? Phi is the magnetic flux. What is B? B is the magnetic field strength. A is the area. And what does cos theta mean? Guys, apart from area and magnetic strength, there is one more thing which is related to magnetic flux, which is the angle to which the conductor is kept in the direction of the magnetic field lines. If it is rotated to some angle, let's say cos theta, so this is going to be the magnetic flux induced in that conductor. Okay, if we see if we are using cos theta, this means phi is equal to B vector dot A vector. Now A is not a vector, so we won't say A vector. In most of the books it is said as A vector. A surface cannot be a vector, it is always a scalar quantity. Okay, now if we want to write a unit to this one, so this thing can be said as Tesla, because Tesla was the guy who created this, and A is meter square, right? So the unit of magnetic flux will be Tesla meter square. Okay, Tesla meter square doesn't ring a bell. So let's put it in something which we know. Tesla meter square is also known as Weber. Always denoted by WB. So I like to write the full equation. This is what we know it as, and this is the short form and for the SI unit of how we are going to reflect our magnetic flux. Thanks a lot, guys.